This week's video is a follow-up on the video we made a few weeks ago about phaser effects on the GrandMA3 console. In this video, we're going to go through a few simple things which has been asked in the comment section on the other videos. How to store phaser effects directly in cues, how we can edit the phaser effect on the GrandMA3 after we stored them into the cues, how we can use phaser effects in presets, how we can edit the presets, and we're going to talk about in the end a little bit about speed masters, how we can attach a speed master to a sequence, and how we can make a learn button to that speed master as well. And finally, I'm going to show you a little bit about how we stop effects again, or how we stomp effects on the GrandMA3 console. So let's start with creating a simple phaser effect just to begin this tutorial. As you can see right now, I recorded all our mega points at 100% in position number one, and I stored it into Q1 of this sequence up here. So let's create a phaser. We say step number one is blue. We select the mega points first. We say step number one is blue and step number two is white. And as we learned the last time, they now start to oscillate between the two positions. We can store this if we say store like this, and we say merge into queue number one, and we clear. We now stored this effect directly into queue number one of this sequence right here. If I want to edit that one and the sequence is selected like it is now, I can simply say edit, please, and it's going to open up the editor in the queue we're in on the selected sequence. If it's not selected, let's just clear this here. I can once again press this one, say edit. Oh, I just need to clear out here. Everything is clear, and let's just check it out. Yeah, everything is clear. I can go up here again and I can say edit Q1, and then I can close this command section down and just push the button here, and this will do the same thing. So if the sequence is not selected, you can just say edit Q1 or Q10 or whichever queue you're in, and then press the go button or any button on this sequence you want to edit. So now we have everything into the editor, and we can just try to see if we can change the speed, for instance, up to maybe 100 like this. We just change the speed. And we can go into the command section once again. We can say update. Do we want to update this queue? And I say yes. I clear this, clear here. And we now updated the phaser effect. So this is a simple way to store a phaser effect and to edit it again. So let's delete this effect once again. We say delete. We say queue number one, please. And it asks us, do you want to delete? And I say, okay. I close it down and queue number one is gone. Let's just once again put into our mega points here, our at full and the position number one. We can store this into our new queue number one. Go queue number one and just clear everything here. Now we start it over. So let's once again create a effect. We say all our mega points in blue, step number one. Step number two is white. So this is another phaser effect. We can just ask it not to use a sinus curve, but to snap between the colors. And we can say store, if we could find the store button right here. And we can put it into an all preset. So let's clear this one. Now we start our small new effect into an all preset. And if I double tap this all preset, it's going to start. I can store this once again if I open my command section. And I can merge it into queue number one. And now we have an effect running in queue number one, which is just switching between two colors. If I want to edit the queue we just made, I can edit it directly into the all preset right here. So if I double tap, it's going to load it into the programmer. I can select the speed here and maybe change it to 100 beats per minute. It's going to change the speed, and I can simply go into our preset here and update our all preset, and I can clear everything, and it has now updated. Even though I updated the all preset, the timing in the sequence changed, because the all preset references, the sequence references the all preset over here. So if I change it over here, it's automatically going to change over here. So this is very useful if you are reusing this effect in many different locations on your console. then you simply do your change over here, and it's going to reflect in every single position where you use this this preset. This could be a song where you use it in one of the first cues, maybe the chorus of the song, and then when you go into the verse, you don't use it. And if you want to change the timing, you can simply just change it up here, or change any part of the effect. So this is how you edit an effect when you stored it into a preset. But what if you want to be able to control the speed a little bit better? You could attach a speed master to your cue, and you can make a learn button so you can simply tap out the speed every time you need it. So let's say we want a speed master to control the speed of this effect. We can simply go in here and up here and go into our master section over here, and we can go into speed, and we can select speed number one. So simply close this one down. We just created a speed master. I would love to have a button down here, which is a learn button, and I'll show you how to use this in a minute. But first of all, we need to attach the sequence to the speed master, or the speed master to the sequence, whichever way you want. So you simply push it. You go into your settings right here, and you go into the speed master here. You'll probably find it at none, and you simply select the speed master you selected in your speed master section, as we did before. Right now I selected speed number one, and the speed scale is supposed to be one, and then we close this one down, and now we have a speed master. So if I turn this one up, it's going to change the speed, and if I turn it all the way down, it's going to slow down. So basically, this is how you attach a speedmaster. It's very simple. And the speedmaster works the same way as your sequences. So if you go into the settings right here, and you go into the handle, you can assign different buttons. So right down here, if I press the key down here, I can go in and select, where do we have it, learn speed. And I close this one down, and now you can simply tap your speed here. So if I simply tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see it automatically adjusts over here. So this is basically how you attach a speed master to a sequence, and then you can simply control it. And this is very useful. You can reuse this speed master many, many times. You can basically go through an entire show with only one speed master if you want to, because all the sequences, this is song number one, if song number two is very different speed, you can simply just tap your speed down to song number two, and then you can reuse the speed master all the time. So it's very, very simple to attach a speed master to a sequence and use it, even though you can use it like this. You can simply turn it up and down. You can tap it out as well. So very simple. You also need to learn how to stop a phaser effect, because starting a phaser effect is actually quite easy. Stopping it is a little bit different. So right now we cleared everything. We are in our cue number one, as you can see here, the phaser is running. What you can do is you don't have to edit the cue. You can simply say all mega points, and then you can say stomp down here in the command line, and then you can push the color down here, and it automatically stomps the color. You can now store this into our cue list here, create a second cue. And if we clear, it's going to start again. But when I go into cue number two, it stumps the color. So this is basically how you stop an phaser effect on the GrandMA3 console. You can do that if you have a pan effect, tilt effect, some gobo effect, color effect, that doesn't matter. You simply stump the part that you want to stop. So that's very, very simple to stop a phaser effect as well on a GrandMA3. So that was a quick follow-up on last week's video, where we started to learn about the phaser engine on the GrandMA3. If you want to learn more about GrandMA3, you can check out the video you can see on your screen right now. And while you're considering doing that, you are more than welcome to giving this video a like. It's going to help it spread out to more people on YouTube. And you're also more than welcome to subscribe to the channel and click the little bell icon so you get notified next time we upload a new video. I hope to see you in the new video, or the next video, or another video on the channel. And until then, happy GrandMA3 programming.